$40 for an 8-ounce bottle of baby oil that some claims protects children from mosquito bites.
Even though there's absolutely no scientific proof that the pricey product will actually keep the bugs off babies. NBC2 investigator Rachel Polansky discovered hundreds of parents going to great lengths to get it.
I'm one of them.
That's right. And this right here, this is what the fuss is all about. You cannot find this creamy baby oil by Johnson & Johnson anywhere in Southwest Florida. But I found it on Amazon for $40. So I wanted to know, why is it so expensive and does it really work?
Cook your vegetables with avocado oil instead of olive oil.
This Southwest Florida mom tries her best to be all natural.
As we, you know, do more research and time goes on, we learn about more of the chemicals and things and what the effects are. And we just are trying to do everything we can to mitigate it.
And even though the doctors recommend it, she's scared to use any bug repellent that contains the chemical DEET on her 2-year-old little boy.
When my husband sprayed DEET on him, we noticed a few hours later that his watch face was actually melting. It just deteriorated the plastic on there. So we figured it probably isn't the best thing for our 2-year-old skin because he would absorb it.
So how does she keep her son bug bite free?
Right now we're using Johnson's baby oil. We actually have the gel.
And even though it's not advertised as a bug repellent, lots of parents say baby oil really keeps the bugs away. Just check out this Pinterest board, this Facebook post, and this parenting blog.
And unlike the creamy baby oil that cost me $40 and was very difficult to find, the regular baby oil goes for just about $5, and you can find it at any drugstore. Still, there's a catch.
Although there's a lot of anecdotal reports, there isn't very much scientific data to support the use of these products.
Dr. Mary Margaret Kober tells me that there's no proof that either product really keeps mosquitoes away.
I usually go with where the science leads. And so I typically recommend either DEET or picaridin. These are two time-tested insect repellents that do work to deter mosquitoes from biting you.
Yay! NBC2 even tried out the baby oil on our producer's little boy over the weekend, and he still got bitten by a mosquito. Despite our experiment and the doc's advice, Jennifer Dorning says she'll keep doing what she's doing.
There's actually no scientific proof that it repels bugs. Does that concern you at all?
No, I just figured if it worked for us and it happened to be, maybe it's a fluke that it's working, but if it's just like the film that it puts on his skin, that works for me.
Now I wanted to know why this specific creamy baby oil costs so much and why it's so hard to find. So I emailed Johnson & Johnson and I found out that it's actually been discontinued. But because of all the recent hype, J&J is hoping to bring it back. I also want to point out that J&J does not market this product as a bug repellent. For the NBC2 Investigators tonight, I'm Rachel Polansky.
Call, email, or download the NBC2 News app and submit your tip now.